What's going on? Josh McCarty from Built in Buffalo. And after a couple quiet days out of one Bills drive, Brandon Beane was back at it in the free agent market on Monday, bringing in two playmakers to the offensive side of the football. And we're going to talk about Trent Sherfield and Damien Harris in today's video. I do want to start with Damien Harris. He is that bigger running back that Brandon Beane mentioned in his press conference last week, looking for a compliment to the 200-pound running backs that they already had in-house in James Cook and Nyheim Hines. When Brandon Beane said that in his press conference last week, a lot of us thought that that would rule out a Devin Singletary reunion, because Devin Singletary, for as productive as he's been for the Buffalo Bills, is only 203 pounds, and you could think maybe that is a little redundant with what they already had in their backfield. Damien Harris is 5'11", 214 pounds. Why I love this move is you are buying a stock that has dipped because he had a down 2022 season. We'll talk about that in a second. But in 2020 and 2021, Damien Harris was the number two ranked back on PFF in the entire league, back-to-back seasons. Now, injuries did catch up to him in 2022. He had a couple hamstring injuries. He dealt with a thigh bruise late in the year. And those injuries, plus the emergence of Ramondre Stevenson in New England, really put Damien Harris behind the eight ball there. But if the Bills can get him back to his 2021 form, where he averaged 4.6 yards per carry, he had 929 yards and 15 touchdowns, this is an absolute steal on a one-year deal. No contract numbers have been reported yet. We can assume that it's probably less than the $3.75 million deal that Devin Singletary signed with the Houston Texans just a couple hours before this deal was reported by the various networks. A couple other things that I really like about Damien Harris: he is very reliable with the ball in his hands. He has three career fumbles in four seasons. Devin Singletary has 13. The goal of this video is not to convince you that Damien Harris is better than Devin Singletary or that Devin Singletary is a bad football player. The goal of this video is to try to help you understand why the role the Bills needed out of their running back behind James Cook and complementing Cook and Hines, Damien Harris is a better fit for that role. One, ball security. Two, he is much better between the tackles than Devin Singletary. If you go back to his 2021 season in New England, he averaged 4.7 yards between the tackles in New England, where Devin Singletary this past year in 2022 only averaged 4.1 yards per carry. Going back to Damien Harris, he had 13 explosive runs between the tackles that season. That's runs of 10 yards or more. Devin Singletary this year only had six. So obviously, cherry picking a little bit because we're using the 2021 Harris that we hope he can live up to with this deal against the most recent version of Devin Singletary. That's why bouncing back and forth between the years there. I think the Bills are in good shape with their running back room. Right now, they have three backs under contract. They will add a fourth before the season starts, but I think with the addition of Harris, compounded with the second-round pick they invested in James Cook, the decent salary they have with Nyheim Hines that they also sent a fifth-round pick for, I think the Bills probably are out of the mix for a first-round running back, and they are certainly out of the mix for trading for a player like Derrick Henry, Austin Ekeler, or Dalvin Cook. The Bills are going to be in good shape with what they have here, and Damien Harris is just a nice, nice fit for what the Bills were looking for at a very cheap cost. If he can stay healthy, that's the million-dollar question. This is going to be an absolute boom for the Bills. Damien Harris was not the only offensive player that the Bills signed on Monday, as they added former Miami Dolphins wide receiver Trent Sherfield to the mix. Where this is interesting is Trent Sherfield, while he is a 4.4 speed receiver and he was the number three receiver in Miami, obviously playing behind the two great receivers in Jalen Waddle and Tyreek Hill, he's most consistently known for being a four-phase special teamer. So what this immediately tells me is this is probably Jake Kumerow's replacement. I would not expect Jake Kumerow to come back with Trent Sherfield on the roster. Spinning this back to running back, Trent Sherfield has been a very high-level gunner in his career. We know Saran Neal is going to be one of the gunner spots. The other gunner on this team has been Tywan Jones. With Sherfield in-house, I am starting to wonder if the Bills are going to bring back Tywan Jones. He didn't have his best season from a special team standpoint last year. and you look at the fact that they are reshaping their running back room, you wonder if the Bills are going to try to save costs and also maybe just take a flyer on a late round running back. You see these guys pop all the time, and take a guy in the sixth, in the seventh round, undrafted free agency, help him understand how to go out there and cover kicks. You get him at a reduced cost, and then you could fall into an Isaiah Pacheco type running back. It happens every year, and the Bills holding one of those running back spots for Tywan Jones, as much as they love him, I think has been a bad philosophy on their part, and it feels like that's the time now where this is finally going to come to an end. So that's where the Sherfield move kind of affects both the running back room and the wide receiver room. But let's talk about the wide receiver room as it sets up now, because we know the names who are at the top. You have Stephon Diggs and Gabe Davis. They already brought in Deontay Hardy from New England, formerly known as Deontay Harris. For more thoughts on Deontay Harris, I would encourage you to look back on Bill's chat that posted Monday morning on this YouTube. We went through all the moves up until Sunday night with the Bills. And then the Bills, with releasing Isaiah McKenzie, still have Khalil Shakir on the roster, and then obviously Sherfield as their fifth wide receiver at this point. The Bills are going to add another wide receiver to the mix. What's interesting is I don't know if they still have the appetite to go out there and trade for, say, a DeAndre Hopkins or a Jerry Jeudy or a Cortland Sutton, or go out there and sign an Odell Beckham. That's what they're going to have to juggle. As it currently stands, I think this wide receiver group is pretty good. Sherfield is a guy that, while he has covered kicks for a lot of his career, is an explosive player. And you saw some of his run after catch ability against the Niners for the Dolphins last year, where he took a little slant over the middle and brought it to the house on the Dolphins, I believe, first play of the game. And you saw the reaction of Dolphins players today, where Tyreek Hill was upset that he was leaving, and Teron Armstead was upset. He tweeted out, "Oh no, he's leaving." So, you know, it's a good sign when guys that were in the locker room with him are upset. But what I like about this move is he's going to be active on game day as what you would imagine being a core special teams player. And like Jake Kumerow, there are going to be instances where he is relied upon to come into the lineup and contribute. And with his speed to burn, 4.4 speed, and his run after catch ability he's already displayed, you would think there would be a way for Ken Dorsey to utilize those skills, maybe in small doses early in the season. But with him being active on game day, maybe he carves out a nice role for himself on offense. We know there is certainly room to grow on this depth chart. There aren't a lot of proven players on this depth chart after Stephon Diggs. We still don't know what's going on with Gabe Davis. So I like both of these moves a lot for the Bills. Neither one of these are going to grab headlines. Neither one of these are going to win you the offseason. They're not going to be the reason why national experts pick the Bills to go to the Super Bowl like last year we saw with Von Miller. But what they do is they fill out your depth chart. They fill out roles on the offense. At running back, you now have a great thunder to James Cook's lightning. And at the receiver, you just have another piece, another speed element to this offense that it is greatly needed. And I love what they're doing with the bottom of their wide receiver depth chart. As the weeks go on, we will start to look at these position groups a little bit more focused and talk about what our prediction is for these position groups, maybe going into the draft. But just sitting here today, I think Brandon Beane has made it some smart additions to this roster. He hasn't splurged, but I think improvements have been made on offense at guard with Connor McGovern, at wide receiver with Sherfield and with Deontay Hardy. And then obviously today, Damien Harris. These are not splash moves, but building up the overall unit for an offense that was already rated in the top five, I think it makes a lot of sense. And it's going to give the Bills flexibility to really go best player available when it comes time for the April draft. Let me know in the comments what you think about the additions of Damien Harris and Trent Sherfield to the Bills. Are you as excited about Damien Harris as I am? Because I think this has a chance to be a move we look back on in December and January and say, I can't believe they got this guy for a one-year deal on what I think will be less than $3 million a year. And what do you think about Sherfield? Is he a guy that, if he wasn't playing behind two studs in Waddle and Hill, could he have had a chance to really get on the field and show his skills? Let me know in the comments. And please, please, please do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. It helps out so much with these videos. We will continue to keep our ear to the ground on all Buffalo Bills news as this offseason progresses. And we will see you next time on Built in Buffalo Quick Hits.